In a recent video, we discussed the criteria for emptying a hazardous waste container according to the RCRA regulations. Now, we want to ship our empty container off-site to be returned, refilled, or disposed of. It's empty, so it should be pretty easy, right? Well, we're about to find out. I'm Roger with Lion Technology, and in this video, I'll tell you when a package that held a hazardous waste or other hazardous material is empty, really truly empty, for the purpose of transportation. To quickly recap our last video, we removed all the hazardous material we could from our container, and there is less than 1 inch of residue at the bottom. As far as US EPA's RCRA hazardous waste regulations are concerned, our container is empty. But US EPA is not in charge of the hazardous materials shipping regulations, the US Department of Transportation is, and our container, well, it's not just a container anymore. We're going to ship this thing, so now, it's a package. Under USDOT's Hazardous Materials Regulations, or HMR, a package that contains a residue of a hazardous material is, generally speaking, subject to the same requirements as a completely full package. You can see that for yourself at 49 CFR, Part 173.29, Paragraph A. So, even though we emptied the container according to US EPA's criteria, when we ship it, we will still need any hazardous materials labels, shipping papers, and placards that would be required for a full package most of the time. Employees who handle and ship these containers must have up-to-date DOT Hazmat training, just like anyone else who affects hazardous materials transportation safety. A package that contained a hazardous material is only truly empty and therefore not subject to the HMR when it is unused, sufficiently cleaned and purged of vapors to remove any potential hazard, or when it is refilled with a non-hazardous material that eliminates the hazard from any residue in the package. Now, the regulations don't provide specifics about how to clean residue or purge vapors from a package. The exact methods you use will depend on the container and the material. Two types of hazmat shipments are treated a little differently: limited quantities and most Division 2.2 non-flammable gases. If you deal with these types of shipments, you can dig into the regulations on screen to learn more. If you remember one thing from this video, remember this. A container can be empty according to the hazardous waste regulations, but be not empty for transportation purposes. If you assume a container is empty and offer it to a carrier without required labels, shipping papers, or employee training, you violated the hazardous materials regulations. That shipment could be rejected, it could be delayed, or worse, it could cause an emergency in transit. The maximum civil penalty for hazmat shipping violations is about $90,000 per day per violation, and it increases every year. One last note on shipping empty packages that held a hazardous material. If the package is empty, according to DOT's criteria, you must remove, cover, or obliterate any hazard label, marking, or placards that will be visible in transportation, on a tanker truck or a tote in a flatbed, for instance. Removing or covering these hazard communications is very important so that, in the case of an incident, emergency responders will know that the package does not contain any regulated hazardous material and they can respond appropriately. Thank you for watching. If you missed our video about emptying hazardous waste containers under RCRA, you can find it on our YouTube channel or click the link in the video description. If you found this video useful, informative, or interesting, please use the like button, the share button, and all buttons not otherwise specified to spread the word and help our channel grow. For training and resources to manage compliance with hazardous materials, hazardous waste, and workplace safety regulations, visit lion.com today, and I'll see you next time.